Hey everyone. I wanted to talk a little bit about like insecurity and paranoia and like bad feelings. So this is really poignant for me today. I just watched this video and I wanted to leave a message on it. And it said that the video owner had blocked me. And that really made me really sad, and like trying to think of like, okay, what did I do or say, or I don't know, it just really hurt. And you know, It takes a lot of bravery to come here and put oneself out there and, you know, be seen and heard. And it's really important not to take certain things personally, but that really got to me this morning. And a couple days ago, I was watching this video by a girl who was getting a ton of hate messages on Tumblr. Like, really cruel bullying type messages. And it's just really unfortunate that we come here to connect and feel safe, you know, find each other, since we tend to isolate offline and still have to contend with the same type of issues that we have to deal with offline. You know, it's a little better because you log in when you know, on your own terms. You can log out, you can block people or delete things or prevent comments, or I mean, there's a million things you can do. But anytime you're dealing with people, there's some risk. And for me, having never been socially adept, I guess, and having a great deal of issues with my esteem and self-worth and everything, and it's hard. And today I'm really struggling with just a lot of stuff, so I guess I'm just a little more sensitive, and I don't know, I'm just hurting, and I mean, mean comments, I'm pretty much bolstered for. I know that stuff's going to happen. Dislikes, I know that stuff's going to happen. But being blocked by somebody, that really, like, shocked me, and, you know, why? But then I got to thinking, well, you know, I have some pretty unusual beliefs. And, my approach to healing in this journey is also pretty unique. But, you know, I'm just here to offer love and support, and it's really sad when you get rejected even for that, you know? So yeah, it just makes me sad that, you know, my intentions here are pure, and that, you know, if you don't want to watch my videos, don't. But I don't know. And so then I was looking around, you know, like other vloggers in this community and noticing that once again, this may be my insecurity speaking, but it sure seems like if you're beautiful, like everybody wants to watch you, and if you're not, not so much. You know, I've seen people come here, like beautiful girls, and they just start out and they get so much, interest, you know, subscribers and likes and stuff. And it kind of hurts because I pour my heart and soul into this place, and every single person who subscribes to my videos means something to me. Like, I'm so grateful, but it always sucks when people unsubscribe too. It's like, what did I do wrong? And this is all so stupid, and I know that, like, it's just me feeling really insecure and, like, worthless and wretched right now, but it's just hard when you really put your soul and passion into something. Anyway, I hope this message isn't misunderstood. I am so honored to share with you guys and be here. And it's okay if I'm not popular here either. Kind of used to it by now. But, it just hurts, you know? When you really strive to connect and offer love and support unconditionally and hope to connect with people, and I don't know. Something else that's always really bothered me, like the big names around here, like the most popular or successful, I guess, names. I always try and reach out to them too, and there have been a few who have never once acknowledged, never once, that I care and I'm there and I'm posting and stuff. Just, if anybody's watching this and there's something I'm doing wrong, or if you can think of a reason that people might not want to talk to me or whatever, please let me know, because if I don't know, I can't fix it. And I want to. I'm not going to name names, but there's certain people that I've followed since I joined, and, you know, actively contributed on their videos and sent a few messages even. And to be ignored, it hurts a lot. I don't expect people to answer every single comment they get, or every personal message even, but if somebody is following you and reaching out for months. At least acknowledge it, you know? That'd be nice. And if something makes you uncomfortable or is bothering you, let them know. Anyway, I've had this concern for a while and I've just kind of been suppressing it and trying to dismiss it as like you're just being insecure. And it's probably not personal. But a block is pretty damn personal. And that really... Not the same people, by the way. It wasn't like a big name blogger or anything, but it just still really hit hard, you know, and just brought up all these feelings. You know, I take responsibility. Sorry, my screen went out. I take responsibility and know that by putting myself out here, I have to accept that I can't be friends with everyone. What are you doing on my bracelet? These hornets really love me. Please don't sting me. Just go away. Thank you. Bye. These hornets love red and yellow and stuff. And yeah. I don't know. I'm just really sad. And like I said, I'm struggling anyway, so everything's kind of amplified, but I just don't understand. And I have to wonder, like, is it because I don't fit the perfect mold in subscribing to the socially acceptable impression of what ED recovery is? Is it because my approach is different, that people just don't want to deal with me or whatever? And that really makes me sad too. You know, I'm doing what works, and I don't know. I just feel like invisible a lot when I'm trying hard not to be, and that's, it's a vicious cycle, because then I want to be, and I want to withdraw, and I want to build up walls, and yeah. Anyway, if anybody's had similar feelings, just know that at least for me, it's not personal. If I don't respond, I do my best to everyone, because I know how it feels to be ignored. And if you're new here and you've just started out, keep reaching out, okay? And just surround yourself with those who do care and are willing to support you. There's so much love here, and it's a beautiful thing, but yeah. Your voice is valid no matter who you are, no matter how you approach dealing with your eating disorder. You are deserving of love and compassion and support. This is long. Alright, I'm gonna go. Much love, everyone. Be well.